Hello guys, welcome and welcome again to my channel. I'm dalitsomoloko. It's our Valentine's week today. Let's talk about the things you need to talk about in a relationship before it gets anywhere. Everything. I just want to say thank you so much to everybody that has subscribed to this channel, also to those that are watching our videos, and to those that are considering to subscribe. Remember to share my videos, remember to comment so that we can all interact. So this week, I should say this week or next week, is going to be Valentine's. So you know Valentine's, right? Some people think of probably proposing marriage. Other people maybe are even getting married on Valentine's Day. Anything can happen on Valentine's Day. So this is gonna bring us to our topic today. Talking about Valentine's, talking about relationships that will develop to turn into marriage. Before we go to marriage, everybody, when you're in a relationship, you have to understand where you're at in your relationship, right? You now have to be very aware. What red flags are you picking? Do you think those red flags are going to take you into marriage? And those red flags, are they going to be okay in your marriage? Would they not develop more? Those are just some of the things that we need to talk about as we are going down into the topic. Today, let's talk about the things you need to talk about in a relationship before it gets anywhere. I am not talking about just starting a relationship today and then you're bringing down all these things and then your partner will be like, hey, God, where did I get this one from? All right? But we're talking about as we grow, what are the kind of things we should talk about? What are the pros and the cons to whatever we're doing in this relationship? What I'm going to tell you today, or what we'll discuss today, doesn't mean that I have done it perfectly myself. I'll be telling you according to my examples or the things that I've seen or the things that I've gone through, right? We will not be talking about other people or something like that, no. There are some things that probably we don't give room into discussing with our partners. And these things that we shove around are probably important things that we should have talked about. For example, when I was in a relationship with my husband, when we were dating, I think we really did not consider about talking things like responsibilities, like the responsibilities that I as a person I have and him as a person he has at home, because these are the things that probably brings so much conflict in a marriage. For example, my husband, before I married him, he was maybe paying his family bills or probably even school fees for the siblings. And I also have my own responsibilities, maybe say when it comes to planting. Maybe I am responsible at home for buying fertilizer for my family or buying even groceries at home. So when we get into marriage and we do not talk about those things prior, it might bring conflict. It doesn't mean that everybody we marry, they have a responsibility at home. I did not have a responsibility at home. He didn't as well. But even so, we should have talked about it. You don't want to do these responsibilities behind your partner's back, because the day that person finds out, my guy, you'll be finished. For you that have the time right now, you might start considering to do such things. Another thing that happens, that needs to be talked about in marriage, is I think the investment, the assets that we have prior to marriage. Do you take your assets to your marriage or you leave them at home? What do you do with your assets? Sometimes you can be working, you can be that you're a single person, but you're blessed enough that you have things with you in your name, your own very things, right? Now you wanna go into marriage. Do you think it's important that you have to discuss together and see what you can do about this? For example, myself, when I got married, I was a student. I had things that I had and they were in a certain country. And now I am married and then we are also moving to another country after the wedding. So I didn't have the money to shift from the things from this side to where I was and then to a new country. I couldn't do that because at that time I don't have a house yet in that new country. I don't know the requirements on how I can ship these things to that country. So we decided that these things that I have, let's ship them back home. So I sent them to my parents' house back home, and then we all started from zero. Like, we went into a new country and started from zero. That was the agreement that we had. It depends on you. For example, let me tell you an example. Before I met my husband, I had somebody who wanted to ask to start a relationship, and the very first thing they talked about is, okay, what about your stuff? What do you think about the things that you have? Okay, what things are you talking about? Oh, your car, oh, your this, oh, your that, your... So, for me, to be honest, I found it funny. God, we haven't even started dating, you're already focusing on, okay, what, you have this, you have that. You know, at that time, I felt like, it was just a turn-off. We ended up not dating, right? Probably not because of that, but because of other things as well. Looking back, sometimes I think that, okay, maybe that person wasn't wrong after all. But maybe it was the time that he asked me for those things wasn't the right timing. We hadn't yet started dating. Now we want us to start talking about this already. Like, give it time. We needed to know each other first, to get somewhere first, and then let's talk about these things that I have or what he has. Another thing that we will talk about is those couples that are cohabitating. In Malawi, the constitution allows you to cohabitate for, like, I think 6 months, and then you're considered as in you are married to this person. Cohabitation sometimes happens mostly that maybe you left home at an early time, probably because you're working in another district or you're working somewhere, and you meet up somebody and you start staying together, and before you know it, maybe you fall pregnant. Basically, maybe kids start coming, you're living together for like some time and something happens. What does the law say about marriage in Malawi? There are about, I think, 3 or 4 types of marriage. There's customary marriage, there's religious marriage, and there's marriage by reputation, which is this one called cohabitation, and there's civil marriage. All those are legal marriages. So when you are cohabitating, you start contributing. Probably you do bills together, maybe purchasing a house together or a land. That marriage is considered legal. So what happens maybe when your partner dies, or maybe the marriage ends, you can't take it anymore, you people want to separate, because this thing is considered legal. Definitely you people are supposed to go through the courts to end up this marriage and to talk about the assets you acquired together. You know, sometimes it's not even acquiring that thing together, but the fact that you people have lived long enough together, then everybody has contributed. You might not contribute financially. Just living in that house, you're contributing. You're contributing to cooking, cleaning. If you have kids, you're taking care of the kids. As a woman, the husband is also taking care of kids. As a man, everybody is contributing. Even if a woman doesn't work or a man doesn't work, but the fact that that person is staying at home and taking care of the home and doing what he can do, he is contributing, she is contributing. So if this marriage fails, it means that whatever you people have must be equally shared. If there are kids, then one has to be responsible for taking the kids. You have to talk about full custody of the kids or shared custody of the kids, and who pays child maintenance. It's not only men that are supposed to pay for child maintenance, even women are supposed to pay for child maintenance. The fact that you have left the man with the kids and you've moved out of the house or you've moved on, it doesn't mean that you're safe from taking care of your kids. Because if a man does move out, you're expecting this man to come and pay for child maintenance. So I think whosoever lives must pay child maintenance if your finances are allowing you to. What happens maybe if the person dies? Marriages by cohabitation are not to families, right? Are not considered legal. They say anangolowana and stuff like that. So you end up not really getting what you were supposed to get. Sometimes the family doesn't even understand the fact that you guys bought these things together. Just because you are not missing for them doesn't really mean that you are not entitled to whatever you guys acquired together. Because it's the two of you that knows about this thing, that probably acquired a land together, a house together, So you are supposed to at least have a fair share of whatever you guys acquired together, just because that person has passed on. To be safe, it's best that when you're cohabitating, at least find a lawyer to be under written agreement, and to have a lawyer to be signing those things. You've acquired the land together, get a lawyer and let the lawyer sign and back you up or be with you to say these guys have bought this land together. You're doing that not because you want to frustrate families, but you're doing that because you don't want to be frustrated yourself. So because if one leaves, one will be left with a very, very difficult task to make these people understand that these things, we did it together. So guys, sometimes think about these things or talk about these things before marriage. Talking about those things doesn't mean that you are an evil person, but you are just trying to all of you being on one page so that you're able to continue your marriage, continue your relationship with full information and full expectations of what's coming after the stage that you are in. Alright guys, so thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to hear what you guys are doing out there on Valentine's and what you thought about this video. If it's helpful or not helpful, please put those comments down there and what you think we should talk about next time we come on this little channel of ours. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.